After years of searching, debate and inquiries, the site of a third airport for London is as uncertain now as it ever was. According to the British Airports Authority, only one thing's remained constant, and that's the growing need for air traffic to have somewhere to go. Their figures claim the number of passengers is growing at the rate of 4% a year. Most of that centred on the southeast. They say airport terminal capacity must be doubled by the 90s, and the site they want to expand is Stansted Airport in Essex. In September 1981, here at Quendon Hall in the Essex countryside, Government Inspector Graham Eyre QC set up shop to decide once and for all if Stansted should be chosen. 13 months and a million words of evidence later, no decision has been made, because this was just round one.
Round two begins here in the appropriately named aviation suite of a hotel in West Drayton. In a rather clever piece of footwork, Uttlesford Council, in whose district Stansted is located, have pushed home their objection by lodging a rival planning application, this time for a fifth terminal at Heathrow.
The main supporter of Terminal 5 is British Airways. They believe that transferring operations to Stansted would be too expensive and claim they've got the backing of most of the other airlines at Heathrow.
But British Airways are unlikely to have it all their own way. An array of local environmental pressure groups are supported on this occasion by Heathrow's owners and operators, the British Airports Authority, who will be supporting their decision to stick by expansion at Stansted. And they'll be backed by objections from 30 local authorities, all against Heathrow's Terminal 5.
After it starts tomorrow, the whole parade is likely to take at least 6 months passing before the inquiry. Once it's over, Inspector Eyre will be sifting through the mountains of evidence to make his report on both alternatives. But with a general election approaching, there are fears that by the time it arrives, the political moment to make a decision will already have passed. This is Steve Clark in West Drayton for Thames News.